Hello there guys, and welcome back to my channel. I haven't done any videos like this before, and I might do them more often if I get a better setup, but this one's for college. But anyways, that'll be fun to do for my channel anyways. So today I am doing the teeny weeny art challenge, where you do one big picture and then you make it smaller and smaller. Today I will be drawing Pico from Friday Night Funkin' / Pico's School. I am in love with this character at the moment, so you might see a lot of him. And this time I'm doing it with a bit of a twist. Let's see what I've got in here. My little money jar. And I've got a 2 pence coin, 1 pence coin. See if I've got any other currency. Ah, 5p. Yes, so I'm gonna use money. Draw around the coin and then draw inside of the coin. I also have a fiver, so yeah, we're not gonna use that. I also have a flattened 1p coin, which you can get at like touristy areas from the machine. Normally you put like a penny in, it gets squished. You normally pay like a quid to get it squished, so we're not using that either, but it's a fun little thing. That's the only coins I've got that are different, so we use those. So I'm gonna draw around maybe a glue stick. You can use a glue stick as well. I think that's the same size as 2p. I'm not using that one. So yeah, we'll just stick with these. We'll stick with these three coins, and I'll just draw like a slightly bigger version of Pico here, and then will go smaller and smaller on the page. So I'm going to get the sketches done, and then we'll do the line work and the colouring here on video. So enjoy! So this is the sketch I have gone with. I kind of started it a bit small. I actually sketched out the circle myself, and then I drew it around the 2p, the 1p, and finally the 5p. So let me tell you a tiny bit about the drawing. So this is Pico from Friday Night Funkin', and I've kind of got inspired by, I believe it's a mod where someone made like evil versions of the characters where they slowly changed to like the shadowy form. Mostly I think it's inspired by week 5, where Lemon Demon appears and there's a shadowy version of the girlfriend. So yeah, I did Pico in that style. I've seen someone on Instagram do some drawings like this as well, so I got inspired by them. I don't know the username right now, so I'll probably put in the description. So I'm going to be using this brush pen to line. I'll probably end up using this 0.1 for the smaller versions. And then I'm going to colour with coloured pencils. So I'm going to try and do a speed draw of that, if I can get like a good picture angle, because my sketchbook will be down here like that, because I don't have one of those overhanging tripods. I have a basic like small one for the phone. So you're going to have to deal with the sketchbook looking like this. So, let's get on with it. So basically, I was able to line that within like 3 minutes. I'm actually getting pretty quick at drawing line work now, so I might not even have to speed that up. So I'm just gonna gently rub out this sketch. See how that looks. Yeah, that looks great. It's alright. I do like the flowiness of the hair that I always give him. Like, I give a lot of characters like flowy hair like that. So I'm gonna use Faber-Castell pencils. It says it right there, and I'm calling it Prismacolor. I don't know why. English number one. So I use these colors for the hair. Because I've drawn him recently, I've kind of memorized what he kind of looks like. So here's the greens. I only have the 12 color base set, so I might have got in watercolors, I'm not sure. Because normally I use these on top of watercolors or markers. So we have the skin tone and then the shading for the skin tone. I have the base 12, and then I have some extras that I bought, obviously. We've got the black, and we need a bit of like that bright pink. So what I'm thinking is going to try and find a pink highlighter, because the cool thing about the shadow versions, they don't use a red as you would typically think with like the evil characters. They use like a hottish pink color, and it looks fabulous. What I have in fact dug out is a glittery zebra pen and this lightish pink one, and I also picked up one of my Sharpies that I normally use for patterning my clothing stuff. But we'll try this glittery pen and this pen for the eye. I mean, it's only a small detail, but I think it'd probably look really good, especially if you if I kind of use on highlights there. Might use a bit of a dark purple as well. It just like adds to like the shadowy like black here. So yeah, let's get on with coloring that, and then we'll have a go at the smaller versions. Let's wish me luck with that. This is the finished drawing that I've done in the slightly bigger size. I'm going to move on to this one, this one, and this one, like I've said before. So, I think it turned out alright. It turns out this pen is actually a lot darker than I thought. The lid is a lot dark, but it's not really that dark, so I thought it'd be a bit lighter, but then again, looking at the ink in the panel, it does look a bit dark, so it's actually turned out alright mixing it with that light pink. I didn't use the Sharpie in the end, I just swatched it out and it was running a bit dry, so yeah. I don't really use pencils all that often, but when I do, in small pictures like this, they look fine. Yeah, I'm not that professional with pencils, but yeah, they still add for nice texture or whatnot. So, yeah, there's Pico. He's very shocked as to what he's becoming. So, I'm gonna have a go at the smaller versions. So, these are my finished drawings of Pico. So, yeah, thanks for watching the video and I really hope you enjoyed it. It was very difficult getting really small with having all like... I mean, I don't have much detail anyways, but it was still kind of difficult. I do work small, but I never work that small, so thanks for watching and I hope to see you in another video like this. Bye.